Hi guys, welcome to Sherry's show. Today we're with Sherry again.
So Sherry, what are we making now?
We're gonna make zaytun parvarde, which is almost like a tapenade, but it's from north of Iran.
Oh.
And my grandmother is from north of Iran, so
which
I learned from her.
Rasht.
She's from Rasht, yes. And I learned from her.
Wow.
Of course, we don't have everything that we need here, or I don't have everything here. One of the herbs is chuchag, which is a local herb.
From Rasht.
From north.
Iran,
that's right. But we're going to try a little bit of a dry coriander to kind of try to mimic the taste.
Yes.
But of course, it's not going to be 100%, but that's okay. It'd be lovely.
Yeah.
And then so.
And this is an appy. And
this
then you serve
is an appetizer. I like to serve it with pita bread.
Mm-hmm.
But I mean, if anybody wants to use crackers or anything else, or a different kind of bread, absolutely they can. Yeah.
Nice. They use it in north of Iran as a side dish too, right?
That's right. Yeah.
Like almost they eat it with their rice and
almost like a salad too.
Salad too.
Yeah, yeah. But it's just delicious. It's lovely. And the more it stays, the longer it stays, the better the taste gets because everything just kind of goes together, right? Yeah, absorbs.
So are you guys ready? Let's cook together. So what's in it?
So we need pitted green olive.
Mm-hmm.
We need pomegranate juice.
Ooh.
Pomegranate paste.
Mm-hmm.
I have some actually, little bit of pomegranate seed just to garnish.
Just to garnish, yeah.
Walnuts.
Wow.
Garlic.
Mm-hmm.
And herbs. So this is dry coriander.
Mm-hmm.
And this one is golpar.
Which is
hogweed, Persian hogweed.
And then Persian hogweed is actually only it's in Iran.
That's right.
But they're now use it in anywhere else too, right?
That's right. Yeah. Many places. I don't know exactly where, but all over the world they use it. But they do call it Persian hogweed because it's from Persia. It's from Iran.
Iran.
Okay. I think it's just the humidity,
weather,
right? That's what it is. So,
and it's some kind of herb too, right?
It is, it is. Yeah, it's dried herb. So I have it grinded, but it comes in flakes.
Flakes, yeah. And, I have it that like flakes and I ground it.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, it smells really good.
Mm-hmm. Mm.
Right?
Yes, yeah.
So first thing we need to do is to grind our walnuts.
Okay.
Okay? About a cup. Mm-hmm. So actually, you know what? Let's just put all of our olives in the dish.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, do you want to do that? Thank you.
I need a spoon though.
There you go.
It's gonna stick together.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm.
So this is, this was about a cup and a half. We will give your audience the proper measurement.
Okay.
But if it's extra, we can keep it.
Perfect.
If you put too much walnut in there, there's nothing wrong with it. But if you put too much walnut, you can see the color changes.
I see.
It'll be more white and more pasty. So if you don't like it, you can put less.
Enough. So that's probably a cup of walnuts?
This is cup and a half, but I think for that, I need about a cup. But let's just see. So you pulse it till it's fine. I like to pulse it because if you let the machine go, the oil is gonna come extra, right? And we don't want that.
Exactly, yeah.
Yeah, looks great.
That's good.
Okay, so before we put that in, I like to make my sauce separate. We need garlic, so I'm gonna just
grate your garlic.
Grate my garlic. It's better to just make your sauce separately and then just add it.
Add it to the
two olives,
Yeah.
At least that's how I do it. You know, I mean, people do it differently, but this is how I make mine. Haven't heard any complaint yet, so must be doing something right. I like lots of garlic. There's nothing wrong with more garlic, and also it goes all inside because it's pitted, right?
Yes.
So it goes inside all
inside
these holes,
too,
right?
Yeah.
So it gets really, really yummy.
Yum. Nice.
All right, so that's that. I want a little bit of lemon juice, not too much.
Just maybe half of the lemon juice is enough.
Yeah, even less is okay. Because the reason I add lemon juice is because we're putting pomegranate paste, and this is extra acidic, you know, to just kind of change it or balance it maybe even. So now we need to put some. If you have pomegranate, make your own juice. But I didn't. I couldn't find any, actually.
Yeah.
So put my pomegranate juice in there. And now pomegranate paste, my favorite.
Where they can get the pomegranate paste?
Like, I think Persian stores. I think so.
Like any other stores, like they don't have it, like in the foreign section?
You know, I think bigger stores might have it in their like ethnic aisle, right? But I'm not sure who. I never looked because I just buy it from Persian stores, which is everywhere, right?
And if they don't have the pomegranate paste, they just can stick to the pomegranate
juice? No, you need pomegranate paste. You absolutely need that.
You absolutely need it.
So I'm going to add my spices in here, or my herbs, I should say, my herb in here. So this is the big taste. Golpar is the big one.
It's a big taste.
The main taste is golpar, right?
So you probably put like
I'm generous. A teaspoon, maybe more. Again, I taste it. And if I want more, I will put more. And same thing with dry coriander. So I like to make it really fine. It's good? It smells really good. So let's just pour this over it. You want to mix that, please?
Sure.
Ooh, let's just get everywhere.
It smells so good.
Doesn't it? So I think. Yeah, so this is pretty good. Yeah, this looks good. So here, let's just add that in there.
You want me to stir it at the same time?
Please. I think we're gonna need more paste, you know. God, that looks really good. I'm gonna add just a tad while you're doing that, a little bit more. I like it darker. So you can just.
So is this a sweet and sour kind of thing?
Depends. If you get a sour paste, then it will taste sour. But if you don't, if you get a sweet one, because some of the pomegranate pastes are really sweet.
Look at that.
Okay, so I'm gonna add some of that. Now mix
Should I mix it?
Mix it, yeah, just to make it
look nice.
Look nicer, right?
So that's just the real pomegranate.
That's it, and we can just plate it, and later we have it. Oh my goodness, that looks really good.
Yeah, can I try one?
Yeah, tell me. Ooh. Now, one thing, I did not put salt in there.
Oh my God,
because olive has, is it good?
Oh my God.
Yeah, because olive has salt, right?
Now, this needs to sit in the fridge or not?
Yes, definitely. You know what? The longer it sits, the better it gets. Oh my goodness. If it stays for 24 hours,
it processes good together.
Yeah, and also all these little holes that they used to be, you know, the pits.
Yeah, it gets marinated
it just gets
with the
in
sauce.
There. Yeah, sauce goes right in there.
Nice.
Isn't it pretty?
Here you have it, you guys. This looks so delicious. Oh my God. They call it zaytun parvade in Iran, which is with olives and pomegranate juice
and walnuts
and oh my God, so many
lots
other
of
stuff.
Lots of garlic.
So let's dig in and try and see how
let's
it tastes.
Let's try it. You go first.
No, you go with me.
Okay.
We want to cheers.
Okay, let's do it.
Okay.
It looks good.
It looks wonderful.
I like the
one
color.
For you.
Just one?
Okay, two for you.
Garlicky.
Let me just put
you have
it
two
in.
As well.
Okay. As you said, and I want to put some of the sauce.
Oh,
too.
Yeah, see, that's the one. There you go.
Do you want some?
Sure, sure.
There you go.
Yum. Oh my gosh.
Hey, cheers.
Cheers. Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, this is good.
So good, so savory. I can taste the pomegranate in there, and the walnut and garlic. Oh my god!
See, this pomegranate paste is the most important one. When it's so, you know, this is not too sweet and not too sour.
You talk, I'll eat it.
No, I'm eating.
Absolutely beautiful.
Yum, yum. You know what?
It's very
I want
easy.
You to try one of my favorite drinks.
Oh, wow.
If that's okay.
Yeah, we're going to cheers it at the end.
That's okay. We can cheers in the middle. And then we cheers again at the end.
Well, there you go. Cheers.
Cheers to you and me for now.
Cheers to Sherry.
To Sherry's. You like it?
Yeah, I love it. What is it?
It's vermouth. It's Italian vermouth. Not too many people like it, but I like it. It's
I like
sweet.
It too.
I think it goes with this because it's sweet, right?
Very good combination.
I'm glad you like it so we can cheers more at the end.
Yeah. Okay, guys, marinated olives. It was just really easy to make if you get all the recipes. And then Sherry's going to give us all the recipes and how much stuff you need to put in. But please go ahead and make it. It's a unique dish and unique appy. And it's very delicious, very delicious. You could have it as a side dish too. But until next time.
Cheers.
Cheers. Thanks for watching, you guys. If you like this video and you want to see more, please subscribe the channel and leave a comment below. I love to read your comments.